नमस्ते हमेशा खुशी हो बिटिया। आई एम जेवी एंड डॉक्टर मीनाक्षी, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ शालाक्य तंत्र, फैकल्टी ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक साइंस। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी विल डिस्कसिंग द सर्जिकल टेक्निक्स फॉर कैटरेक्ट एक्सट्रैक्शन। द फर्स्ट टेक्निक वी हैव डिस्कस फॉर द इंट्राकैप्सुलर कैटरेक्ट एक्सट्रैक्शन। What are the indications of the intracapsular cataract extraction? Now we will study the surgical steps of the intracapsular cataract extraction. First step is the superior rectus, a bridle suture, is to pass to fix the eye in downward gaze. Then second step is the conjunctival flap, which is fornix based, is prepared to expose the limbus, and hemostasis is achieved by wet field or heat cautery. All surgeons do not make conjunctival flap. Then the third surgical step of ICC is a partial thickness groove or gutter is made through about 2/3 depth of anterior limbal area from 9:30 to 2:30 o'clock, 150 degree, with the help of a razor blade knife. Then here's an image of the first step, the passing of superior rectus suture, and B image shows the fornix based conjunctival flap. The C image shows the partial thickness groove. Then the fourth step is the corneoscleral section. The anterior chamber is opened with the razor blade knife or with 3.2 mm keratome, and section is completed using sclerocorneal scissors. Then the fifth step is the iridectomy, or peripheral iridectomy may be performed by using the iris forceps and Dewecker scissors to prevent postoperative pupil block glaucoma. There is an image of the corneus, completion of the corneoscleral section, fourth step, and E is the image of the fifth step, peripheral iridectomy. Then the sixth is the methods of lens delivery. In ICC, the lens can be delivered by any of the following methods. First is the Indian Smith method or Smith Indian method. Here the lens is delivered with tumbling technique by applying pressure on the limbus at 6 o'clock position with lens expressor and counter pressure at 12 o'clock with the lens spatula. With this method, lower pole is delivered first. The second method of lens delivery is the cryo extraction. The lens surface dried with the swab, retracted up, and the tip of cryoprobe is applied on the anterior surface of the lens in the upper quadrant. Freezing is activated at the temperature of minus 40 degrees Celsius to create adhesions between the lens and the probe. The zonules are ruptured by gentle rotatory movements, and the lens is then extracted out by sliding movements. In this technique, upper pole of lens is delivered first. Then the third technique of lens delivery is the capsule forceps method. The Oruga's capsule holding forceps is introduced closed into the anterior chamber, and the anterior capsule of lens is caught at 6 o'clock position. The lens is lifted slightly and its zonules are ruptured by gentle sideways movements. Then the lens is extracted with gentle sliding movements by the forceps, assisted by a pressure of 6 o'clock position on the limbus by the lens expressor. The fourth method of lens delivery is the isofix method. This technique is obsolete and thus not in much use. The fifth method of lens delivery is the wire rectus method. It is employed in cases with the subluxated or dislocated lens only. In this method, the loop of the wire rectus is slid gently below the subluxated lens, which is then lifted out of the eye. Then the seventh surgical step of ICC is the formation of anterior chamber. After the delivery of lens, iris is deposited into the anterior chamber with the help of iris repository. A repositor and chamber is formed by injecting sterile air or balanced salt solution. Then eighth step is the implantation of anterior chamber intraocular lens. The IOL held by forceps is gently slid into the anterior chamber. Anterior haptic is produced, pushed in the inferior angle at 6 o'clock position, and upper haptic is pushed to the engage in the upper angle. Then the ninth step is the closure of incision. It is done with the 5 टू सेवन इंटरप्टेड सूचर्स 8090 और 10-0 नायलॉन. Here is an image of the cryolens extraction, which is the sixth step. Then there is the next step is the lower left side insertion of Kalman multiflex intraocular lens in anterior chamber, and the next is the corneal scleral suturing. The next step is the of ICC is the patching of eye. Is done with the pad and sticking plaster or bandage is applied. Shift the patient to bed. Then 11th step is the 10th step was the conjunctival flap, which is reposited and secured by wet filled cautery. Then 11th is a subconjunctival injection of dexamethasone 0.25 ml and gentamicin 0.5 ml is given. Then 12th step is the patching of eye is done with the pad and a sticking plaster or bandage is applied. Shift the patient to bed. Here is an image of the dress dye. Then remove the dressing from the eye. Then we see the traditional stitch. Then when there is no stitch, after removing the stitches, then green goggles are used. Then next surgical technique of cataract extraction is extracapsular cataract extraction. The major portion of anterior capsule with epithelium, nucleus and cortex are removed, leaving behind the intact posterior capsule. The indications of extracapsular cataract extraction are presently it is a surgery of choice for all types of adulthood as well as childhood cataracts unless contraindicated. The contraindications for extracapsular cataract extraction are the subluxated and dislocated lens. Then the types of extracapsular cataract extraction, as we have already discussed, there are three surgical techniques. The conventional extracapsular cataract extraction, in short ECCE. Second is the manual small incision cataract surgery, that is SICS. The next is phacoemulsification. So first is the conventional ECCE. The surgical steps are superior rectus bridle suture, then conjunctival flap, fornix base. Then third step is the partial thickness groove or girder. Fourth step is the corneal scleral section. Fifth step is the injection of viscoelastic substance in anterior chamber. Viscoelastic substance such as 2% methyl cellulose or 1% sodium hyaluronate is injected into the anterior chamber. It maintains the anterior chamber and protects the endothelium. Then the sixth step is the anterior capsulotomy. Can be performed by any of the following method, like can openers technique or linear capsulotomy or continuous circular capsular helix triple C. Then next step is the removal of anterior capsule. Then the eighth step is the completion of corneal scleral section. Then ninth step is the hydrodissection, that is the separation of capsule from cortex by injecting fluid between the two. The balanced salt solution injected under peripheral part of anterior capsule to separate corticonuclear mass from the capsule. Then the 10th step is the removal of nucleus. After hydrodissection, the nucleus can be removed by any of the following techniques, by pressure and counter pressure method or the irrigating wire vectis technique. Then the next step is the aspiration of the cortex. Next step is the implantation of IOL. The next is the closure of the incision. 3-5 interrupted sutures are placed. Then removal of viscoelastic substance. Then conjunctival flap is reposited and secured. Then next subconjunctival injection. And in last, the patching of eye is done. From A to I, these are all the surgical steps of ECCE. Then manual small incision cataract surgery. The surgical steps are superior rectus suture, and then conjunctival flap and exposure of sclera, then hemostasis, then sclerocorneal tunnel incision. And this is done by the following components, like external scleral incision or sclerocorneal tunnel or internal corneal incision. then next step is the side port entry, then next step is the anterior capsulotomy, then next step is the head to dissection, then next is the nuclear management by prolapse of nucleus into anterior chamber or by delivery of the nucleus outside through corneoscleral tunnel. Then next step is the aspiration of cortex. Then next step is IUL implantation. Then next step is the removal of viscoelastic material. Then next step is the wound closure. These are all the surgical steps of the small incision cataract surgery. Then phacoemulsification. The surgical steps are corneoscleral incision, continuous curvilinear capsular helix, hydrodissection, nucleus is emulsified and aspirated, then remaining cortical lens matter is aspirated, then IUL implantation, then removal of viscoelastic material, then wound closure. The surgical techniques for ECC for childhood cataract. Surgical techniques employed for childhood cataract are essentially of two types: irrigation and aspiration of lens matter, and second is the lensectomy. First, we will discuss the irrigation and aspiration of lens matter. The first, it can be done by conventional ECC technique, by corneoscleral tunnel technique, which include manual SICS technique, phaco aspiration technique. The surgical steps for irrigation and aspiration of lens matter by corneoscleral tunnel incision. It is 1 to 5 initial steps up to marking of side port entry are same as SICS. Then 6th step is anterior capsular helix of about 5 mm size. 7th step is irrigation and aspiration of lens matter. 8th step is the posterior capsular helix of about 3 to 4 mm size recommended in children to avoid the posterior capsule opacification. 9th step is the anterior vitrectomy. 10th step is the implantation of IUL after inflating the capsular bag with viscoelastic substance, heparin or fluorine coated PMA IUL preferred in children. The next step is the removal of viscoelastic substance is done, and then the last step is wound closure. Then the second surgical technique of extracapsular cataract extraction for childhood cataract is lensectomy. In this operation, most of the lens, including the anterior and posterior capsule, along with the anterior vitreous, are removed with the help of a vitreous cutter, infusion and suction machine. Childhood cataracts, both congenital and developmental and acquired, being soft, are easily dealt with this procedure, especially in very young children, like less than 2 years of age, in which primary IUL implantation is not planned. Lensectomy in children is performed under general anesthesia. Then next topic is the intraocular lens implantation. Presently, intraocular lens implantation is the method of choice for correcting aphakia, and the types of intraocular lens. These are the anterior chamber intraocular lens, iris supported lens, and posterior chamber lenses. So here are the images of the Kalman multiplex anterior chamber lens. Second is the Singh and Worst iris flow lens. Third is the posterior chamber lens, which is a modified C-loop type. So here we complete the management of the cataract. Thank you so much. This session is powered by digital version 2.0, Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University. I hope you are satisfied with my digital session. If you have any query, please mention in the comment box. I will resolve it. Thank you so much.